Brilliance Audio presents the unabridged recording of Miracle at Coney Island, How a Sideshow Doctor Saved Thousands of Babies and Transformed American Medicine by Claire Prentice, performed by Colleen Marlowe. Preface. It was the last place you would expect to find a baby. At the beginning of the 20th century, visitors to Coney Island could pay a quarter to enter a scrubbed white hospital ward, incongruously situated on the boardwalk just yards from the sea. Inside, scores of tiny premature infants were tended by trained nurses in starched uniforms, supervised by the benign figure of a dapper man in a physician's white coat and a showman's flashy spats. In an amusement park famous for restless innovation, Dr. Martin Cooney's infant incubator exhibit was as long-running as it was popular. The real, living, breathing premature babies who occupied a row of incubators drew crowds for four decades, from 1903 to 1943. Cooney operated much the same open-door policy as Coney Island itself. He made no distinctions regarding race or class. All infants were welcome. What's more, he didn't charge their parents a penny. All the costs of medical care were covered by the entrance fee. The story of how Michael Cohen became Dr. Martin Cooney and saved thousands of premature babies has fascinated me ever since I came across it while researching my book, The Lost Tribe of Coney Island. The idea that tiny infants were once exhibited alongside circus animal and human freaks horrified and intrigued me. What also struck me was the fact that Martin Cooney's story was not more widely known. I set out to discover as much as I could about the career of the man dubbed the incubator doctor, a process that has taken several years. In a career spanning half a century, Cooney was believed to have saved 6,500 lives. It is an extraordinary achievement for a man who spent his career not in a hospital, but on the boardwalk and at amusement parks, world's fairs, and expos across America, in London, Paris, Mexico, and Brazil. His incubator shows were seen by millions of people and brought him fame and fortune. Along the way, Cooney performed the kind of vertiginous trick we associate with the carnival. He turned what was normally private, intimate, and domestic into a public spectacle. Were his motives that of the showman or of the doctor come visionary determined to help a group sidelined by mainstream medicine? Was he a performer, a healer, or some mercurial blend of both?
Sample complete. Ready to continue?